You're watching Newstainment Television.
Okay, now back to T20.
Yes. Let's have some fun. Yeah.
Your best childhood memory?
It's difficult to choose a best childhood memory because I think childhood is what it is because it's got an assortment of great memories. But if I had to think back to my richest childhood memory, it would be the day my dad offered me perspective. I was about 5 years old. I was sitting on the stairs. My parents were getting a divorce and I was obviously very troubled about it. And he came home a little late. So he saw me sitting there on the steps of our house. And he said, "What happened? Why are you looking so upset?" So I said, this is a four and a half year old who looks up at the father and says, "I have too many problems." So he kind of smiled at me and he said, "Come with me." And he took me to my room. And my parents had put the globe in my room. So he pulled the globe down and he showed me the globe. And then he says, "This is Andhra Pradesh." At that time, Hyderabad was a part of Andhra Pradesh. So this is Andhra Pradesh. This is the state we live in, India. This is the country we live in. And then he pointed Hyderabad, which was a dot on the map. And he said, "This is the city we live in. This is Hyderabad." And it was just a dot. And I remember this in this child's mind, because children see everything literally. I remember looking at the dot and saying, "But Papa, Hyderabad, it's just a dot." And he says, "Now imagine how big your problem is." It was the most powerful life lesson I think my parents could have ever given me, because that's what we tend to forget in life. We lose perspective. At the end of it, we are like, I remember what Arundhati Roy said, that we are not entirely insignificant. But in the larger perspective, we are so, so, so small.
True. Your first crush?
My first crush was a senior in school, who was like the hottest boy in school. He was athletic, he played the piano, he played the guitar. He was very, very eloquent and confident. And I remember getting butterflies in my stomach even when I saw him at a distance. And I get really shy and smile. I don't think he ever found out I had a crush on him, but he was so cute.
Now he knows.
Well, he does.
Kohli versus Dhoni.
अरे ऐसे नहीं हो सकता एक बाप है एक बेटा है how can I choose
one song that changes your mood of the day when you play and it such changes your day
changes my mood it I'm very I listen to all kinds of music and I have like this playlist that but I think a happy song is Pehla Nasha anytime any year because I think my childhood association with that song is so strong, it just takes me back to a very happy place. I remember prancing around the house with my arms all wide, dancing and singing.
Is there a role that you regret not accepting, that you thought you should have accepted?
There are a few, but I'm not telling you.
Okay. Tell me later when the camera is off. One film, best film of yours that you want to see again and again.
Oops, my God, I'm not that narcissistic. But I think a film I can watch again and again that I was a part of was Lagi Rahunga. Yeah. It's a film that I can watch again and again. It's such a beautiful story and a message.
One actor you look up to?
In India?
Anywhere.
Many, but Meryl Streep. I think Meryl Streep is an extraordinary artist, but also an extraordinary voice, and I love what she has to say.
One memorable gift you ever got that you...
The moon. My mother gifted it to me one birthday.
And best compliment?
Chanda Mama mere hain.
Best compliment?
I think the best compliments that I receive are from complete strangers who tell me that they think I'm a good human being.
Favorite flower?
My favorite flower is jasmine. Indian jasmine.
Favorite food?
Mughlai, Hyderabadi. You can never take the Hyderabadi away from me.
Yeah.
Mritika Salan.
Favorite politician?
You're actually asking me that question. Oh my god, you want me to name a favorite politician? Dear god. I think somebody I've really admired across, like, over a period of time, and this has nothing to do with political parties, it's just admiration for the individual, is Sushma Swaraj. I love the fact that she's always been a very strong voice of the people, for the people. And I think in this term that she's been a minister, she's, her interactiveness with civil society, you know, the fact that she's approachable, you can tweet her and she'll reply to you, and you know it's her, it's just remarkable.
Tell me, how did your hubby propose to you and finally say yes?
He proposed to me on Brooklyn Bridge in New York.
Okay.
It was a bridge that actually was a very significant part of his life journey. He decided to leave New York and move to India on that bridge. And I guess if he hadn't moved to India, we wouldn't be together. So that bridge brought us together.
Favorite color?
My favorite color is white, because it's a spectrum of all colors.
Favorite person?
My favorite person? My mother.
Favorite book?
Many favorites, but I think a life turning, like a really deeply inspiring. So there are three books that really changed my life and my thoughts. One was Anne Frank's Diary. The other is Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. And the third would be Tuesdays with Maury.
Okay. Why did they change your thought?
I guess because I found these books at a stage in my life where it kind of opened perspective and helped me understand myself and the world a little better. and deeply impacted me emotionally. I think that's why.
One role that you want to play, somebody else has already played.
Oh, that somebody else has already played.
Yeah, that I wish I was doing that.
That's a tough one, because I've actually never seen a film, and other than when I was a child. I mean, I was to Hum Dil De Chuke Sanam, Hum Aapke Hai Kaun. I wanted to be in all those films.
You wanted to do all the roles.
Yeah, I wanted to be every Madhuri film. I wanted to be in the movie.
Favorite drink?
H2O.
Okay. And your style statement?
Simple, chic.
And last one? The last movie you saw?
The last movie I've seen is Gully Boy.
This is Newstainment Television.